Welcome to the Queensland Storyteller. My name's Kim Dodsworth. Today's story is written by William Saroyan, and it's called The First Day of School. He was a little boy named Jim, the first and only child of Dr. Lewis Davey, 717 Matai Building, and it was his first day at school. His father was French, a small, heavy-set man of 40, whose boyhood had been full of poverty and unhappiness and ambition. His mother was dead. She died when Jim was born, and the only woman he knew intimately was Amy, the Swedish housekeeper. It was Amy who dressed him in his Sunday clothes and took him to school. Jim liked Amy, but he didn't like her for taking him to school. He told her so. All the way to school, he told her so. "I don't like you," he said. "I don't like you anymore." "I like you," the housekeeper said. "Then why are you taking me to school?" he said. He had taken walks with Amy before, once all the way to the courthouse park for the Sunday afternoon band concert. But this walk to school was different. "What for?" he said. "Everybody must go to school," the housekeeper said. "Did you go to school?" he said. "No," said Amy. "Then why do I have to go?" he said. "You will like it," said the housekeeper. He walked on with her in silence, holding her hand. "I don't like you," he said. "I don't like you any more." "I like you," said Amy. "Then why are you taking me to school?" he said again. "Why?" The housekeeper knew how frightened a little boy could be about going to school. "You will like it," she said. "I think you will sing songs and play games." "I don't want to," he said. "I will come and get you every afternoon," she said. "I don't like you," he told her again. She felt very unhappy about the little boy going to school, but she knew that he would have to go. The school building was very ugly to her and to the boy. She didn't like the way it made her feel, and going up the steps with him, she wished he didn't have to go to school. The halls and rooms scared her and him, and the smell of the place too. And he didn't like Mr. Barber, the principal. Amy despised Mr. Barber. "What's the name of your son?" Mr. Barber said. "This is Dr. Lewis Davey's son," said Amy. "His name is Jim. I am Dr. Davey's housekeeper."
"James," said Mr. Barber.
"Not James," said Amy. "Just Jim."
"All right," said Mr. Barber. "Any middle name?"
"No," said Amy. "He is too small for a middle name. Just Jim Davey."
"All right," said Mr. Barber. "We'll try him out in the first grade. If he doesn't get along all right, we'll try him out in kindergarten."
"Dr. Davey said to start him in the first grade," said Amy. "Not kindergarten."
"All right," said Mr. Barber.
The housekeeper knew how frightened the little boy was, sitting on the chair, and she tried to let him know how much she loved him and how sorry she was about everything. She wanted to say something fine to him about everything, but she couldn't say anything. And she was very proud of the nice way he got down from the chair and stood beside Mr. Barber, waiting to go with him to a classroom. On the way home, she was so proud of him, she began to cry. Miss Binney, the teacher of the first grade, was an old lady who was all dried out. The room was full of little boys and girls. School smelled strange and sad. He sat at the desk and listened carefully. He heard some of the names: Charles, Ernest, Alvin, Norman, Betty, Hannah, Juliet, Viola, Polly. He listened carefully and heard Miss Binney say, "Hannah Winter, what are you chewing?" And he saw Hannah Winter blush. He liked Hannah Winter right from the beginning.
"Gum," said Hannah.
"Put it in the wastebasket," said Miss Binney.
He saw the little girl walk to the front of the class, take the gum from her mouth, and drop it into the wastebasket. And he heard Miss Binney say,
"Ernest Gaskin, what are you chewing?"
"Gum,"
said Ernest, and he liked Ernest Gaskin too. They met in the schoolyard, and Ernest taught him a few jokes. Amy was in the hall when school ended. She was sullen and angry at everybody until she saw the little boy. She was amazed that he wasn't changed, that he wasn't hurt, or perhaps utterly unalive, murdered.
The school and everything about it frightened her very much. She took his hand and walked out of the building with him, feeling angry and proud. Jim said,
"What comes after 29?
30, said Amy.
"Your face is dirty," he said.
His father was very quiet at the supper table.
"What comes after 29?
The boy said. 30, said his father.
"Your face is dirty," he said.
In the morning, he asked his father for a nickel. "What do you want a nickel for?" his father said.
"Gum," he said.
His father gave him a nickel, and on the way to school, he stopped at Mrs. Riley's store and bought a package of spearmint.
"Do you want a piece?"
he asked Amy. "Do you want to give me a piece?" the housekeeper said. Jim thought about it a moment, and then he said, "Yes."
"Do you like me?" said the housekeeper.
"I like you," said Jim. "Do you like me?"
"Yes," said the housekeeper.
"Do you like school?"
Jim didn't know for sure, but he knew he liked the part about gum and Hannah Winter and Ernest Gaskin.
"I don't know," he said.
"Do you sing?"
asked the housekeeper.
"No, we don't sing," he said.
"Do you play games?"
she said. "Not in the school," he said. "In the yard we do." He liked the part about gum very much. Miss Spinney said,
"Jim Davy, what are you chewing?"
"Ha, ha, ha," he thought.
"Gum," he said. He walked to the waste paper basket and back to his seat, and Hannah Winter saw him, and Ernest Gaskin too. That was the best part of school. It began to grow, too. "Ernest Gaskin," he shouted in the schoolyard, "what are you chewing?"
"Raw elephant meat," said Ernest Gaskin.
"Jim Davy, what are you chewing?"
Jim tried to think of something very funny to be chewing, but he couldn't.
"Gum," he said. And Ernest Gaskin laughed louder than Jim laughed when Ernest Gaskin said, "Raw elephant meat."
It was funny no matter what you said. Going back to the classroom, Jim saw Hannah Winter in the hall.
"Hannah Winter," he said, "what in the world are you chewing?"
The little girl was startled. She wanted to say something nice that would honestly show how nice she felt about having Jim say her name and ask her the funny question, making fun of school, but she couldn't think of anything that nice to say because they were almost in the room and there wasn't time enough.
"Tutti frutti,"
she said with desperate haste. It seemed to Jim he had never heard such a glorious word, and he kept repeating the word to himself all day.
"Tutti frutti," he said to Amy on the way home.
"Amy Larson," he said, "what are you chewing?" He told his father all about it at the supper table. He said, "Once there was a hill. On the hill there was a mill. Under the mill there was a walk. Under the walk there was a key. What is it?"
"I don't know," his father said. "What is it?"
"Milwaukee," said the boy.
The housekeeper was delighted. "Mill, walk, key," Jim said.
"Tutti frutti."
"What's that?" said his father.
"Gum," he said. "The kind Hannah Winter chews."
"Who's Hannah Winter?" said his father.
"She's in my room," he said.
"Oh," said his father.
After supper, he sat on the floor with the small red and blue and yellow top that hummed while it spinned. It was all right, he guessed. It was still very sad, but the gum part of it was very funny, and the Hannah Winter part very nice.
"Raw elephant meat," he thought with great inward delight.
"Raw elephant meat," he said aloud to his father, who was reading the evening paper. His father folded the paper and sat on the floor beside him. The housekeeper saw them together on the floor, and for some reason, tears came to her eyes.
And that concludes our story for this week, The First Day of School by William Saroyan. I'm Kim Dodsworth. Thanks for joining us. I'm looking forward to bringing you another story from the Queensland Storyteller this time next week.